Hey, what's going on, everyone, and welcome to the Gold Camo Guide for the Shield in Modern Warfare. We're going to go in-depth today on everything you need to know on how to fast and efficiently unlock the Riot Shield. I think it only took me 3 to 3.5 hours of in-game game time to actually unlock all 100 camos for the Riot Shield. I think I have some pretty good strats that you guys can use to unlock it quite fast and efficiently too. Gotta pause the video here, guys, for a sec. In the background, I'm doing bot gameplay in private match because I wasn't bothered enough to go into public match and play with the Riot Shield again. It was frustrating. Okay, continue. What we're gonna do is when we go through each camo category, on screen what you guys are gonna see is an example. I will have the actual category, the challenge you need to complete the category, followed by the best game modes I've found to complete the category, as well as the maps I excelled at while I did the challenge. Since there are no attachments for the Riot Shield, I want to talk about ways to level up your Riot Shield even faster, because what I found is I would finish an actual category for camos, say the Splinter category, and I wouldn't have Topo unlocked yet. So the best way to level up your Riot Shield is actually going to be to absorb bullet damage from enemies. What I mean by this is just have enemies shoot you and you will unlock 50 XP for every 300 damage your shield absorbs. And then if you absorb too much damage from the same person, the XP drops off from like 50 to 40 to 30 to 20 and then 19, 18, 17, so on and so forth until I think you get to like 1 XP per damage blocked or whatever. Space this out so while you're absorbing damage from your Riot Shield, preferably in ground war because that's where you get shot the most at, in between absorbing damage, try to get some kills in there as well, and you will level up your Riot Shield weapon level super fast. I want to touch base on perks and equipment really quick. The perks I used was double time so I can run faster, restock so I can restock my tactical equipment, and tracker so I could see where enemies were going based off their footprints. So if I was playing an objective based game mode or just TDM in general or ground war, whatever, I could track enemies where they were going just by following their footprints that they leave on the ground. For my equipment, in hardcore, I like to use the stun grenade, the flash grenade, and the smoke grenade. I use the stun grenade and the flash grenade to stun enemies and then just get an easy kill because they won't be able to aim at me or see me in general. And I like to use the smoke grenade because if there's a building that a lot of enemies are in or an objective that enemies are on, I'll throw the smoke so they can't see me coming, and then I'll rush in there with double time and get a couple of shield kills, which is really easy to do. In core, I don't use the smoke just because once I get in the smoke with an enemy, unless I can actually land those two hits to get the kill, 9 times out of 10 I'm getting outplayed in those smoke situations and I'm getting killed. Starting off with the first category, this is spray paint. To complete all 10 camos within this, you have to get 200 kills. Now, I highly recommend playing hardcore as much as you can just to speed through kills because it is only a one hit kill in hardcore, so you can just hit an enemy once and they will be dead. However, it's also vice versa, so every enemy will be able to shoot you and kill you within 1 to 2 bullets at most, if not all ranges. So I recommend playing hardcore headquarters and hardcore domination because it is objective based game modes. The enemies will always be pushing the objective, so if you can time where the enemies are spawning to the objective, you will be able to meet them halfway and pick off a couple kills here and there. However, do not challenge enemies at long range with the shield, even if you're in crouch walking towards them so they can't shoot you at all with the shield. In hardcore, all it takes is a Molotov or a grenade to be thrown at you and you can't defend against that at all. So stay in close quarters areas and hold your corners and camp just a little bit. I know I don't like camping at all. Just with the Riot Shield, you have to. And then when enemies walk through door frames or anything, you can just pick off the easy kill. So the second category is Woodland. And to complete this, you have to get 50 kills while injured. And since you are running around with a shield in most gunfights, you will be taking damage and being injured for most of the time. So you should be able to knock off Woodland without even paying attention or focusing on it. However, if you do need to focus on this challenge, say it's the last you are yet to complete, just hop in Ground War, preferably on Karst River Quarry or Krovnik Farms, chill around the B, C, and D flags where the enemies are in high populations, and then really push their spawns and objectives. This will make the enemies injure you, as well as you will be able to easily pick off enemies because they will be in close proximity to you. If you need a little bit of help while pushing the objectives too, feel free to use stun grenades and flash grenades to disorient the enemies. This will make it so much easier for you as well to get those kills with the shield because they won't be able to see you because they'll be flashed or they'll be stunned, so they'll be turning very slow so you can get behind them and sneak in a few quick kills. Digital is 50 kills from behind to complete all 10 camos within the category. To do this very simply, on objective-based game modes, flank behind the enemy as they're pushing an objective, and then you can just come from behind them and get a few kills from behind. As well, if you're playing hardcore, if you are camping by a doorframe and an enemy walks through without noticing you, you can kind of just chase him down and get that kill from behind. As well as if you're playing ground war, use those stuns and flashes and disorient enemies on objectives, and you will just be able to get a crazy amount of kills from behind. This is a really easy challenge to do. Dragon is really easy to do. All you have to do to complete this is get 30 kills with Dead Silence. Once you get your feel upgrade active, just activate that Dead Silence and rush in there. Enemies won't hear you coming, and you will be able to get a bunch of kills. Super, super easy. Also, using Dead Silence just helps you immensely with the shield anyway, so you will complete this category while using Dead Silence super fast. To complete Splinter, all you have to do is get 50 crouch kills. Really easy to do because you'll be crouching most of the time regardless with the shield, just because you're trying to protect yourself while pushing enemies. The only odd time that you won't get crouch kills is when you're rushing like a maniac in hardcore, or just like pushing objectives in ground war like crazy. Honestly, the crouch kill's really easy to do. Topo is probably the hardest challenge to complete for the Riot Shield, so I highly recommend playing hardcore, because in core game modes, to get a double kill, you have to make contact 4 hits, 2 for each player. So if you're playing hardcore, double kills will be a lot easier to get, because all you have to make contact with is 2 hits. And if you're using stun grenades and flash grenades, you'll easily be able to knock this out. If you really want to play core because you're having a lot of frustrations with hardcore, play ground war, and same thing, when you're on objectives, just use those stun grenades or just find weak enemies and double kills will come naturally. To complete Tiger, all you need to do is get 25 kills near smoke grenades. A teammate's smoke grenade, enemy's smoke grenade, or your smoke grenade will all count towards this challenge. I highly recommend doing this in hardcore. However, if you do this in core, make sure that you're doing it in high traffic areas and also close quarters areas. To unlock Stripes, you have to get 10 buzz kills. This is really easy. All you have to do is just kill an enemy on a kill streak. So if they have like 2 kills, they're on a 2 kill streak, and just kill them. So as long as the enemy you killed has killed one enemy before you kill them, you're ending their kill streak and you're getting one of the 10 buzz kills. To complete Reptile, all you have to do is get 25 finishing kills. This is when you go behind an enemy and hold the melee button, and you'll do like a little cinematic animation where you'll put your shield away and you'll just stab them in like the abdomen a couple times, and then yeah, just do the 25 times and you're good to go. And the last but not least challenge is Skulls. 25 times, you have to get 3 kills without dying. Just get 3 kills without dying with the shield and you're good to go. And at that point, you should have all 100 camos to finally unlock that spectacularly beautiful gold camo for the shield. Well, guys, I hope this video helped. Playlist in the description for every other gun that I've gotten gold so far. I've made a gold gun for, I think, 12, 13 guns now. And by the time I have Damascus, every single gun will be down in that description. Without further ado, guys, if there is one, I'll see you in the next one. Peace.